Evening, or morning, or afternoon, wherever you are. Happy Mother's Day to all you beautiful mums out there in the US. The UK have their Mother's Day in March. Sometimes it falls on my birthday. So happy Mother's Day to you all. And even to the fathers who are out there being mums as well. Right, what has been going on? Oh my God, so much. I only had 2 nights off. Well, I had 1 night off Saturday. I was on Friday night. That was a good ride. Well, very good ride. Apart from all the interference with the videos and whatever. I had Saturday night off. Even though my grandson said, you can go and do your work now, Mum, Grand, on the laptop. I went, no, sweetheart, it's okay. Because I knew he wasn't going to go to bed early that night. He'd go to sleep in the afternoon. I said, I'll spend my time with you. So that's what we did. Then Sunday comes, I'm here. But it's like, this case with Sebastian Rogers is crazy. Crazy as hell. What the heck is going on? Right? I'm not joking. I've been trying to keep up with some of the YouTubes, right? Getting my information I needed ready for tonight. And I've got about the press release. What's his name? That press release of Seth's Mike. Or whatever his name is. I've seen that video. And I've got data about Robin Rogers. And a list of videos I've got here to watch. It's unbelievable. And then today, for some reason, I found out that apparently, I don't know how true this is. Apparently, Steph, the dog handler, is a fake. Please, what is happening? Right? So, I don't know what to think. If anyone can update me on that, I'd love it. Been trying to catch up in the last hour. The last hour, I've been trying to catch up. Hope everyone okay. Hold on. Hope you can all hear. So it's like, what is going on? Can we not just all pull together and find this lad, Sebastian Wayne Drake Rogers? Please, put our differences aside and let's find him. Those who can get out there, boots on ground, fair dues. Because I know if I was in the US and I was anywhere near there, I'd be boots on ground. But if I wasn't anywhere near there, I'd be printing off flyers and putting flyers out. Wherever I lived. So, can you just let me know in chat if you can hear me okay? So, I don't know what's been going on. I don't even know where to start. You know what I mean? Hi, Tracy. Good to see you here. Hope you're having a nice day. So where do I start? Well, I think we need to go back to the house. Hi, SG. I think we need to go back to 108. Gafford Court. Happy Mother's Day to you. I don't know. I don't know even where to start tonight. I really don't. I am just flummoxed by everything that's been going on the weekend. Right? We now got that PR and Seth not now saying if we want to go, but we got the PR telling us, giving us the right of way to go after to say what we want about CP and KP. Well, I'm sorry, Mike, if that's your name. We was anyway. Whether you did or not, we was going after them. Because once we found out that lad was not Sebastian, he went back. The attention went back to 108 Stafford Court. And that's where they are. Well, should be, but not. So, what happened? On the 25th of February, he went out. He had stuff. What was it? How did it CP put it? He put it as though Sebastian should be grateful he went out, sort of thing. That wasn't the words he used. I can't remember the words he used. Oh, God. And I thought, hold on. That don't sound right. Anyway. So, they got up. Katie, the mother, made breakfast. Oh, by the way, fun fact, she made breakfast. I made breakfast today for my grandson. What's so fun about that? Right? So, does she not cook then? And then he has FaceTime. So she said. Then they had a phone call asking if they could go and pick up the niece. And then met up with the niece and the aunt. And they went to BJ's, where he had a colossal popcorn. Perhaps he doesn't like your breakfast and you didn't eat your breakfast and you're still hungry. Just saying, Katie. Perhaps you should stick to takeouts. Right. And then they went bowling. Then after that, Katie said she come home, got the groceries off, went back out for dinner at the steakhouse. I left there, got in the car, come home. Sebastian did his chore, which is to take the bins down or to put the rubbish out. He did that. He then went and played in the bedroom, in another room. 9 o'clock, she said, Sebastian, it's time for you to go to bed. So like a good little boy he is, after being so stimulated all day, senses are sky high, rocky, through the roof. He's come toddling through. Night night, mummy, I love you. Night night, puppies. And off to bed he goes. And were to believe that? Right, Katie. I believe everything right up until you left the steakhouse. From that time on, when he got in the car, from that time on, I don't believe a word. I don't. And CP, sticking up for his wife, fair dues. Right? Fair dues. Every man should stick up for his wife. But, oh God. He's not sticking up for her. He's not sticking up for her at all. He's controlling her. Right? Yeah, I watched a video today on YouTube. Can't remember which one it was now. I should have written it down. No, I didn't. Shame. So, and it was about some guy had phoned in and was talking about working for, I think it was CP's father, stepfather, I should say. Now, I was listening to that and I'm thinking, do we believe him? Has he been watching a lot of YouTube channels and just been putting little bits together to make a story up? I don't know. I really don't know. That's probably why I didn't write it down, because I didn't find it plausible what he was saying. I just kept thinking, oh, it says something. Okay, I've heard that somewhere else. Oh, I've heard that somewhere else. So it's like he's obviously been watching YouTube channel, or he's on Twitter or Instagram or whatever he's been watching, and he's picked up this. But he was saying how the stepfather, he'd overheard or heard someone talking about a stepfather and a hitman, paying for a hitman. I go, are you kidding me? I swear to God, if you used to make a film of this case, just alone up to now, just make a film up to this day, I don't think anyone would believe it was true. I really don't. I think I'd be sitting there going, you know what, that was a good film, but that wasn't based on true experience. Believe me, loves. If this goes out as a film, it's based on true experience and true wording, true understanding. Anyway. So, you can't go on about the father, the stepfather saying things like hitmen and hiring hitmen. And he believes CP is involved, and the things he used to say about Sebastian, how he called him the R word. Well, we all know that, and that's one of the things I clicked on for. Hold on, you've been watching the YouTube channels. You really have been watching YouTube channels, because this is too alike now. It's saying too many little things that have come out on YouTube channels and put them all together to make us like one. Apart from about the stepfather. Right. So, and I'm thinking, oh God. When, you know what annoys me? What really fecking annoys me? And I know I had one woman come through to my comments and say, stay calm, and whatever. It'll be what it will be, and all that. I'm going, thank you. And I'm trying so hard to stay calm. I really am. And I was trying so hard at the beginning to be that person sitting on the wall. But I soon fell off that wall. And I'm trying to stay calm, I really am. But these people now are coming out and went to what, 75? Oh yeah, I did write that down. I believe it's 76 days now. 76 days. Why haven't these people come out sooner? Right? Like, some have come out early on, right, but they've not been public. They've been talking to other YouTubers or whatever, not gone public. So what are these ones that are going public? Out now. Why didn't you come out when Sebastian first went missing? You know what I mean? Are they that scared of CP? Come on. Come on. I have been up against bigger and harder men than that. I went up against one guy once. And he came down. I lived in like a block of flats where there was six flats in a block. Right? So it wasn't a big block. Exactly, SG. Right? And I remember one day, the woman who lived upstairs above me, her child, I'm cleaning my passageway by my door and down the stairs. And all I've heard was, oh, Mom, what? Such and such just shut the front door. I went, you're joking me. It shut me out. Right? I went, where's your mum? Oh, she's upstairs. Anyway, with that, this guy comes down and he's going on. I went, are you his mother? No. Are you his father? No. Well, get the fucking mother down here. Pardon my French. Get the mother down here. She's busy. Right? And I said, I don't care. He's just shut me out. You know, I'm going to have to go call a locksmith. And because I've already called them out once, they charge you the second time. Right? I said, so when I get the bill for that, can you pay it, please? No. I said, oh, yes, you will. Right? And he stood there, and he's like two or three steps above me. So he's looking down at me. And I went, I'm not backing down. Anyways, turned away. I said, yeah, go get the organ grinder, not the monk. I don't want the monk, I want the organ grinder. Right? Well, he's turned away and walked away. And my neighbour went to me, said, do you know who you're speaking to? I went, no, do I care? He's the sort of guy that would put a knife to you. I said, yeah, well, let him. Let him try. You know what I mean? I was always going up against the men. Always. Always, always, always going up against men. Right? And my husband could just stand back. Oh, let it go. Oh, not getting in between that. Right? And I think it's because I grew up. Like, I had two older sisters, but then I had three older brothers. And a younger sister. So there's me and then three older brothers. So I grew up with my brothers. So I grew up not to get messed about. So I'm sorry, but CP is a piece of S. Something I wipe off my shoe before I walk in the house. Is that dirt, the trail of dirt that the snake leaves behind as it squirts wiggles along the ground. It's not the snake's belly. He's the dirt under that snake's belly. You can't get any lower than that. My audio's a bit choppy. I don't know why. I really don't know why. I don't know why it's choppy. I've checked everything this weekend. And everything's plugged in correctly. And all whatever. I don't know why it's choppy. I really don't. I don't know. I've turned my echo down because I remember the first time I did it, I didn't post that video. Because on that video, when I watched it before posting it, there was an echo. So I turned my echo right off. That's okay, Alan. You don't have to. Bye. Right, so I've tried everything. I don't know what it is. I could unplug it, put it back in, but it'll still be choppy, and I don't know why. Hold on. I don't know what's causing it. And I'm right up on my mic so that you can hear me. Could that be the problem, that I sit too close to my mic, maybe? Right, I'll sit away from a bit and let me know if it's still choppy. Because I have tried everything now and I don't know what's causing it. And even when I play videos, you get like a crackling noise and I don't know why. But I have looked into and I have signed up to a new streaming app. And once I figure out how to work that one, I'll be using that app instead. But it seems very complicated, this app, the other app. This one's a lot easier. I've set it up, but I don't know how to bring videos up in it. I really don't know how to bring videos up into it. So that's what I've got to figure out, how to bring a video up into, to share a video onto my screen and to share pictures and information. And I tried going through it yesterday while my grandson was having a nap. But there's so much information I've got to read up on. And I thought, I'm never going to get all this done. Not in my life am I going to get all this done, because I've got so much to sort out for my life. So I've got to watch these videos and then I've got to try and sort this out. Is that better? It might have been because I was too close to the mic thing. But otherwise, I don't know what else it is. I don't know. There's two apps that jam on my taskbar at the bottom. I'm going to close. Don't know why they open it for. Yeah, the other app I've joined up to, hold on, I'll tell you what it's called. It's called Streamlabs. That's the new streaming app I've signed up for. Streamlabs. Where this one was so easy to set up. So easy to set up. And it's the same price as this one, Streamlabs. It's the same price as StreamYard. But I don't know why I get a lot of interference when I'm playing videos. Because I can watch a YouTube channel on here. And I don't get no interference. But as soon as I put it up on my streaming app, I get that interference and I don't know what's causing it. I mean, I'm not so tech savvy. So I don't like to mess about in the settings and all that lot, because knowing my luck, I wipe everything clean. I keep one button, thump, everything's gone. Anyway. I will not the in that telephone call, will not play it, because it is disturbing, it is threatening, it is vile, and it doesn't help the case of Sebastian Rogers. Right? Now, I am going to play the PR video, and I think that's on my Facebook account. Oh god, I've got to go right back up there. Oh. But if anyone knows anything about Streamlabs app, please let me know how to figure it all out, because So much reading. Mom. And I'm not into reading. I wish I'd be one of those readers that could do that quick reading where you read one paragraph or some other page and then turn over reading another paragraph. I can't do that. I have to read one paragraph at least three times, depending on what I'm reading, to get the gist of what they're saying. I'm getting there. For some reason, it's going very slow up the screen. And then we've had them statements by Robin Rogers. Right? And I'm thinking, hold on, 1 minute you're having a go at Chris and Katie. Then a little while later, she puts out another statement saying how she spoke to the TBI and over this information. I'm thinking, how come you can, they're telling you this information? And you can talk about it, but law enforcement won't try. So I'm going to find it. What was I going to do? What it? God's sake. So I'm trying to find that PR's video. I'm gonna have a fight on you. I did share it. It's only a short one, it's only about 9 minutes long. How long is it? About 10 minutes. It's 10. Oh, 19 minutes. Fine. So, I've got here, like, don't know if you know former PI posted. No, I don't. Where did you supposed to? Q is an organisation with resources that helps to find missing children. Sumner County isn't using them. Why aren't they using them? Is it a free organisation? Why aren't they using them? Don't make... Why aren't people letting, like, you got CP and KP not letting the dog handler do the job, right? And I'm not on about Seth, I'm on about Jules or Julio, whatever the name is. And you got law enforcement not using, right? I'll have a look. Hold on, I'm just going to put this up. Right, we're just going to watch this, and then I'll go and have a look. Right. Because this is on my Facebook page, so I can't go searching at the moment. Right.
And I was doing a job. There's no protection anymore. If you guys want to go all in on him, you do what you want to do, because there is no partnership anymore. It's over. It's done.
It is so ridiculous to me when you told me that. Well, first of all, you told me, which I knew nothing about, that leaked phone call as well. I don't know if that's something, I'm sure everybody on this call doesn't know, or everybody here doesn't know about that. Do you want to sort of, do you feel comfortable talking about that?
So there was there was a phone call that Chris Proudfoot had with one of our PIs, and that phone call was recorded. It was shared within a few members of our team, and somehow or another it got out and it was not released by either one of our PIs. Let me be very clear on that. It was not released by me, obviously, because it destroyed everything that I'd been working to build. But what happened is, you guys remember, I'm sure, that Web Sleuth interview where it turned into a train wreck, and Chris was on there, Chloe, the PI, I was on there. He was attacking her. She talked about, you know, some documents that she had that she hadn't released. Chris got mad about that. He was on the phone with Heather, our PI, and he was calling Chloe everything but a white woman. And I mean, he was disgusting towards her. He threatened Seth on that phone call. You know, and it's just been too much. I mean, calling and pranking people while there's a child that's missing, and then, you know, acting like you know, just essentially making fun of an autistic child. I mean, it's just, you know, next after the next, and there's just not, there's not any more, there's no more partnership, and there's not going to be. It's, you know, we're going to do our thing with Seth, and they can shoot arrows, then that's fine, but we're not going to sit here and take arrows anymore and not shoot them back. We've had it. We're done. Seth's done. I checked with him 3 times today to make sense where he's at, and we're not going back. So it's over with that whole partnership routine.
I mean, I literally, so, you know, the regulars, if you guys invite as well, you guys are more than welcome to come up. I don't know if Tina's in here, whoever, you know, wants to come up, please feel free.
Hey,
Nikki. Oh, okay.
I'm getting ready though.
Okay.
She's another friend of mine.
We're yeah, I know. That's why I wanted her to come up. First of all, I just cannot even, I don't even have the words to explain what this fuckery is about. Like, I just, I don't even, I had to say fuckery because that's what Nikki said, and that's the perfect word for it. Like, I mean, I don't even, like, I don't even have the words.
It's true. No, it's true. When I don't have words, it's fuckery. It's just a big fuckery.
I mean, I just don't even have the word. Are you okay, buddy? Everything okay? Okay. Words for it. It's, I don't, I mean, do you think now, and I'm just going to ask you point blank, do you think now with everything that's going on that they might have had something to do with it? Does this make you think differently about things?
I think they damn sure.
I mean,
let's face it. All right. Everybody's got the records. They've seen the records, all that bullshit. I mean, I think we can all agree that whether I'm not going to sit here and tell you, I know that somebody's hands were involved in this, but the environment went in, and Seth's mom said it yesterday, then she said something different today, but she alluded yesterday to the environment that child was living in. So if somebody didn't do something to him, somebody created an environment that made that kid not feel like he was safe. So are you responsible literally, or are you responsible figuratively? But responsible is responsible. And when you don't get out and search for your child, and you say that it's because law enforcement told you not, it's bullshit. I'm searching for my child, and I'm just going to say it. Everybody's been saying it, and I told you guys when I got pissed that there was no turning back, and I'm not tired. I may look tired. I'm not tired. I'm pissed, and I've had it. I've had it with his bullshit. I've had it with him disrespecting women. I've had it. I'm done. And he's going to see the side of me now that he saw on the phone a week and a half ago when he got slick with me.
Said she'd be arrested for sure. I mean, honestly, I missed it. I don't know what.
Yeah. So I just came in. I got a message and I'm like, I don't know what's going on. And I came in and.
Well, Proudfoot has been fucking up with Tony. He's saying shit about him and he's done with them. But go ahead, sorry.
Intended to be some, you know, some guy, you know, that he wasn't on a talk show, just cracking jokes and, you know, just acting like a clown. And you know, we've got a laser focused dad that's been looking for his child, and we got a clown over here acting like a clown, being a clown. And you know, we're just not going to partner. We're not going to put up a facade anymore that we're partnering with people that don't seem to give a shit. And you know, we don't want anybody saying anything bad about the Proud Fits. We're not doing any of that. If y'all want to fire away. We don't give a shit anymore.
I want to just say a couple. Well, so one person said, be careful because his family has money. So they just said, be careful, Tony, his family has money. I know you're not, that doesn't worry you, but I just wanted to tell you that. Cause I would be at watch your back. Tony CP's family has money. So do you want to give maybe a high level overview? No, that you're also working. What else you're doing now?
I'm officially the spokesperson for both fathers. The fathers are now friends. They talk daily. It's a joint effort. There's not a whole lot.
I'm sorry. When he says both fathers, he doesn't mean both of Sebastian. No, he's talking Sebastian's real father, biological father, his only father, and Caleb. Sorry. I just wanted to clear that up. Go ahead, Tony.
Randy Harris and Seth Rogers. So those guys have linked. I got Randy's permission to represent Seth. They talk daily. Randy sends him scripture. They talk back and forth. It's a very, very unique and cool and fun relationship for those two guys. Yes, I'm the spokesperson for both families. I've been spending 99% of my time with Seth because there's not as much going on right now with Caleb's case, unfortunately. I will tell you that we just secured an interview with Brian Enton for Caleb's family. I've been working on that for about three or four weeks. You know, 99% of my time right now has been spent, you know, working with Seth. And, you know, the last 8 days has been cleaning up messes and trying to protect the Proudfoots. And we're just not going to do it anymore. And our whole team is not going to do it anymore. We're not doing it on Facebook. We're not protecting anybody on Facebook. We're done with all that. If you got me protecting the Proudfoots by controlling Seth, and then you got Chris out there firing arrows, it's not fair to Seth, and we're just not going to do it anymore. So, you know, I don't give a flip about somebody that's got money. I mean, I'm not exactly a broke old man either. And I'm not running from anybody. I don't hide behind my name. You know, I don't use fake names. I don't do any of that. I mean, I am who I am, and I'm easy to get a hold of. And this is about a missing child. It's not about anything else. And I just don't give a damn about all that.
Sorry about this. I'm trying to get screen so you can see.
And I can speak. Sorry, go ahead, Peachy. I'm sorry.
No, I was just going to say, I know you don't. And, you know, you got to do what's best for the situation and for Sebastian. And I completely agree. And it doesn't sound like this has been the best for the situation. And I just really hate that it's gone the way that it has. And, it could hinder things. So I think you're making the right decision.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think anybody in the public believed in that, that new pact anyway. You know, this ocean lady that's on here, she's been real good too. So chasing crime is coming, by the way.
Okay. Oh, great.
And if you can get more boxes, some of these people want to come up. We'll talk all night. I want everybody.
If people want to come up, just request. I have a Don wanted to know, can you state which creator posted the horrible threat from CP?
Let's see. What was the question again? I was trying to read these comments.
Which creator posted the horrible video about CP?
Horrible video. He'll pick one.
So multiple people did. So he's threatening people. He's threatening someone.
Yeah. When that phone call got leaked that he was bad mouthing Chloe. That's all over the internet. In that extended phone call, you'll hear him threaten Seth in that phone call.
I'll keep going down. First of all, thank you guys to everybody who's sending love. You guys are awesome. Let me just go down and say a couple of the Chris. Who did Chris fire arrows at? He fired arrows at Tony. And
more importantly, Seth.
Yeah.
And our PI. And our PI.
Yeah, the way he spoke to a woman.
Yes, absolutely.
He fires arrows at everyone, though. He is probably the most arrogant, self-centered. In my opinion, I mean, he could put a lot of people off just because of the way that he is, and it's just it's really sad.
Like I said, I'd take 5 minutes with him, and I would love it.
See an interview. Between the two.
He likes to go after women. He doesn't not want to. Uh-oh.
Well, you're acting really bad.
I am?
Better.
Hi, Chase.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. I'm real good. Good.
You are really bad. Really bad.
I am? Let me drop. I'll come right back.
No, I am.
I think it's
CT girl. Yeah. CT, drop out and come back in, please.
So, Tony, did he get upset with you about last night's conversation?
Who's that?
Chris.
I don't know if he did or not. I don't give a shit anymore. I told you guys last night that I was about at the end of the rope with him, and we're done now. There's no partnership. There's no nothing. The gloves are off, and if he wants to sling bullshit towards us, he's going to get it back. Now it's that whole partnership.
Right. Somebody said, was his cousin legit? I don't know. As I said, you've had his cousin come out and say something. You've had this guy come out on a YouTube channel who supposedly worked for his stepfather. I was talking about the stepfather and Chris and the things they used to say. And apparently there's another guy who would know more, he said. He'll try. And I think it was Jay's for Justice, it was on there, said he'll try and get him to contact her. I don't know. It's just people coming out the woodwork, and it's doing my head in. It's taking the focus off Sebastian. Now, I will carry on with this, but I want to find this information about... that was it. I want to get that Warriors page up. Not going. Justice for Warriors. Just happy if I put the right one. Why's that not showing up on my Facebook page? There it is. It's just taking a long time. Come on. Oh, God's sake. Yeah, that's the one. Thank you. Oh, right. Okay. So this was put up 6 hours ago from the Heather, the ex-PI for Seth. She no longer works for him. But she does, if he wants her help, she will come back and help. It says, when I came into the Sebastian Rogers case, one of the first things I did was get to work trying to get the CUE Center involved. Seth registered his son with CUE, and I put them in contact with the jurisdictional agency right away. Anyone who knows anything about CUE knows that they have such a high level of respect for law enforcement that they will not do anything about their blessings. Anyone who knows CUE knows that they are also very respected by law. She just said that, right? They have massive resources and have helped to find thousands of missing persons around the country. So tell me, why hasn't Sumner County Sheriff's Department given their blessings to them? Make it make sense. Didn't they? Why wouldn't I give CUE their say, come in and help us? You know what I mean? Why wouldn't I? I don't think they ask for money. Most of these organizations for children are all no money in town. So why wouldn't I ask them? Perhaps we need to start getting onto law enforcement. CUE, where are they? Why haven't you asked them to help? Why aren't you using their resources? It does make you think. Are they scared to get help because it makes them look a failure? Sorry, I'm having trouble with words. Failure. I'm not saying it again. So does it make them look like they failed by asking other people for help? No. It doesn't. It shows you've got the knowledge and understanding that, look, we haven't got all the resources, and there's resources they have which we could use. Do you know what I mean? Why don't they? You know what? I'm going to share this on my page if I can, if it lets me share. Yeah. Sharing it onto my page. I'll tag it all later. I'm just posting it for now. So that doesn't make sense, SG. Why wouldn't I do that? Let's see if I can find some more information out about them. Oh, come on. I'm not seeing anything for this organization. No. I'm not seeing anything there. I'll dig into that. I might have to word it differently. because sometimes I can type something in and it doesn't give me the information. So I have to sit back and think of certain keywords to use, and I punch them keywords in and it comes what I want. So, but that, I'm not going to show no more of that interview because it's just Michael, whatever his name is, just going on about the phone call, which I think is vile. And I'm not saying it was, I'm not saying this is true, but I think, in my opinion, I think Seth gave that phone call recording to Nina. Because I heard, the last I heard about that case, that was on Thursday, there was three recordings brought into the court. For the court, yeah. Three. There was one of them, that phone call, or was it all three of them, all about Chris and his behaviour, like the way he's being on YouTube channels, you know what I mean? And all that lot. So, but as his cousin was legit, I don't know. I really don't know. So, I view those people, like that person today phoned, well, not today, but the other day phoned up a YouTuber, was talking about his works and whatever. And I'll probably have some threats thrown towards me. He said, but I'm not scared of them. And I think this is a problem. They are in with the law enforcement. Put that in your comments. Right. I think they are in with law enforcement. And but why would TBI not be doing anything? Well, we know TBI's track record. There's four people in Tennessee missing. Four. Summer Moon, Utah Wells. Liana, whatever. There's two other girls, and then Sebastian. Four missing children. Because they're all under, I think, well, the two girls, I think the one's 18. But they said her mental age is a lot younger. T, I'd like to know. I'd really like to know myself, because I went, took my grandson home today. I took him home. And while he's outside on the trampoline that they brought for them, he's in his high heaven when he's in that trampoline. Right. And his mum trusts him to stay out the back and not to go out that main door of the block, just to come upstairs. And he does. He does. He doesn't go out that main door. Anyway, so while he's downstairs, his mum was sorting out Olivia. So I was talking to the Evergrande and I said, this case. Is a shit storm. Really is. It's crazy. I don't know what Tennessee are doing. Why won't TBI just hand it over to FBI? They know they can't deal with these complex cases. They know they can't do it. They haven't got the resources to. Hand it over to FBI. Allegedly, yep. It is sickening because there is a child involved. Exactly. We all have to meet our maker one day. We really do. And there's a special place in hell for these people. for any person who is helping a family by threatening them, following them, intimidating searchers, you name it. Anyone who is doing that, there's a special place in them, the reins of fire. Right? Because you're just as bad as they are. And someone actually said today, right, about Robin Rogers. I didn't reply to this. I didn't even put a comment on that post. Because I don't know all the facts. Right? All I know is Sebastian swore her to secrecy. Right? Now, if my grandson or grandchild come to me and said something like that, I'd say, look, you want me to talk to your mum and dad about that? Or really, we need to talk to your mum or your dad about this because this can't carry on, Sebastian. You know what I mean? I'd have encouraged him with me by the side of him to speak to his dad. Joseph Jules. It's partly down to my accent because I'm from the UK. I'm from Birmingham, UK. But people are saying the sound is a bit choppy. I don't know what I can do. This is a brand new mic. Brand new. Right? External mic. Because the mic on the laptop is crap. And so I went out and brought a brand new mic. I've had it, what, about 2 weeks, 2-3 weeks? And people are saying it's a bit choppy. So I've pulled myself away from the mic a little bit. But a lot of it is down to my accent as well. So I'm really sorry. I am trying to speak as slow as I can. Sometimes I get a bit overexcited and I just ramble on. So I'm sorry about that, I really am. I am working on it. I will check my mic out again tomorrow to see if there's something I've not done. I'll check it out on my laptop, but every time I go into my laptop and I'll check for my mic and everything, it comes up all clear. It comes up 100% go. It's not telling me any problems. So I don't understand why it's choppy. Right? So. Anyway. Name on Meta AI came up. She was a former sheriff. This is not true. No, it isn't. Even the internet is giving out false info. Yeah. Yeah. Was that on AI? Because I wouldn't trust AI. I really wouldn't. I don't use AI. I go and, I go to Google or even try and get some. But I get blocked a lot of times because of where I am. I'm not in the USA, so it won't let me go into it. So I don't know. Right. Right. What was I going to do? Meta AI. I'm going to check that out. But I wouldn't trust it. I really wouldn't trust that. Right. Now, the other thing that came out, JLR video on X. Why have I put that down? I can't remember why I put a lot of things down. But it's obviously something to do with this case. And it'd be on my page now because I would have shared it onto my page. Oh yeah, I thought this is agree with this. Right, I don't agree with them stalking them. Right, because we've got people who are doing searches and being told they're being stalked. You know what I mean? So I don't agree with people actually going up to this campus site, Caravan Park, and stalking them. But if you're driving past in that area and you're driving past, then there's nothing much else you can do. Right? So, I'll show you this because I liked it in a way, a little way. Just a little chuckle. Hold on. It's literally 13 seconds long. Okay, that's fine. Right. She drives past, hoots her horn, and shouts, "Wake up, Chris." But I don't think he's there because his car's there. But I don't think her car was there. Watch it again. Was her car there? No. No, he was at work. Because he's been put his own notes. Yeah, it's on night, so we'd be at home. So where's her car? I heard she'd gone away on a holiday somewhere. Last week, Thursday, Friday, I heard something about her going away somewhere. I'm thinking, no, it can't be right. That cannot be right. No way would she be leaving to go somewhere else. Not without Chris, unless she's gone with his parents. Right? So... what else was it? Like, something else about JLR? No, that's what I was. No, it's got to be this. Right? Hang on. It'll come up in me. Right, and it's this Robin Rogers. Now, that's the grandmother to Sebastian and the mother to Seth Rogers. Now, I've actually got the other part in my emails, which I'll pull up in a minute. But she goes, shame on Chris Fairfoot and shame on Clooming at. Now, I'm not keen on that YouTuber, who reportedly speaks with him daily. How dare you make a mockery of my grandson's disappearance? But we all know how you really felt about Sebastian. And how you treated him. CPS records do not lie. Well, how do we know? Because we've not seen the CPS records. We've not seen them. Neither has Seth. You know what I mean? None of what has come out the past 2 days is helping find Sebastian. None of it. None of it, right? And then he goes, anyway, I'll carry on ringing. He says, you know exactly what happened to Sebastian. Your smart-mouthed husband said so early on in the investigation. Now, that got my ears pricked. I thought, watched all their interviews. I can't remember them saying anything on that, on those lines. So now I'm thinking, I'm going to have to go back and watch all these interviews on top of all these interviews I want to watch. The longer this goes on, the worse the outcome for you. We'll find him. That's the only thing there. We will find him. Right? And then what got me was the next one she put out. I'm thinking, oh no, I've got to go into my other email. You know what I mean? Oh, where is it? Right. Yeah, we've just seen that. So it's the next one. Right, and I'll zoom in as far as I can so that you can see it. Right. I've got to just add it to my screen. Right. What's that one? I mean the legs talking isn't helping. Long. I don't trust that. What allegedly is Robin's post or her actual post? You know what? I don't know what to believe. I really because she just had a go at CP and KP then in that first one. Yes. Then it's gone. I had a long discussion with the special agent in charge of the TBI. Good one. I just want to clarify a few things and hopefully stop some of this drama. Robin, you put some information out there which was not to be true in the first place. I am so sick to death of all the trauma vultures. Conspiracy theories. I want all of this to stop and for the focus to be where it should be, finding Sebastian. Exactly. One, TBI has interviewed both CP and KP extensively. Okay. They have both been polled and passed. Yes, Kate took more than one poll. Just more harm than good to keep into everyone's background. I understand the concern of whether Sebastian might be with his other maternal grandmother, but really all this is all this necessary? Well, I'm sorry, but if you just said that I understand the concern of whether Sebastian might be with his other, you're putting out there as well. We're trying to stop that rumor. Yeah, I've just noticed in this one she says Kate, and in the other one she says Katie. But we're trying to squash that rumor about Sebastian being, well, it isn't his ever maternal grandmother, though. Okay. Right. I understand what she's saying now. But really, is all this necessary? Well, yeah, because if she's got Sebastian, then yes, they need to know. Then she just goes on to say, please, if you have credible tips, call them into law enforcement, Summer County, Tennessee Sheriff's Office. TBI 1800 TBI fine. You have no idea how much you're speculating my family. But she does admit, yes, I am guilty too, but what am I supposed to think when Katie was the last one with him and all this negative information is being spread around? No, no, just say what you're thinking, right? You agree Katie was the last one with him, yeah? We all agree. Why? And all this, what negative information we want Katie to talk up. We just want to hear from Katie the truth. What happened that night? Because something definitely happened. Please let Laura handle this. Huh, that's a joke. They won't even get CUE involved. Please, but the rest of this has to stop. Do not react to negative outbursts. You're just perpetrating drama, and we, the Rogers family, quite frankly, cannot take any more drama. Thank you for your understanding. I'm all for this grandmother and mother. You know what I mean? I really am. But as it said, the Kate in this one and in that first one, it was Katie. Would it have been? Hang on. Oh, God. Could it have been a misspelling or something instead of saying Katie? She just put Kate. Because I've got a sister called Kathleen, and my mother phone her up. And if anyone else but Kathleen answered the phone, say, is Kate there? Or Katie? No, he just says Katie there. Go by that name, go by Kath or Kathleen. Right? So they'd say, sorry, there's no one here with that name. It really would. If they used any name but Kath or Kathleen, the husband and the children, if they answered the phone, say, sorry, there's no one here with that name. And my brother would turn around and say, put my sister on the phone now. Right? But we just want Kathy to tell us what happened. Please. You want the truth, we want the truth. You want Sebastian found, we want Sebastian found. We all want Sebastian found. But it goes back to 108. What thing am I wrong again? Stafford Court. Goes back to there. What happened between leaving that steakhouse and getting in the car and coming home? Right? So we're not just talking 9 p.m. on the night time. We're talking 6:30 p.m. on the night time. Right? So 6:35. You know what I mean? 6:30, 6:35. So we're talking that. So that's an extra 3 hours. Even if it was Sebastian's out at whatever time, what happened in that house after he took the bins out or took the rubbish out? What? Was he too hyped up? Would he not go to sleep? Did she give him some more medication to get him to sleep? Did she use any of her own medication? Because she's probably thinking, well, this isn't working. I'll just give him one of my tablets. That would be a no-no. It's like someone told me, I was told once, and I even watched something on TV or on a Facebook thing. If you're asthmatic, right, walking, and you haven't got your inhaler on you, and you have an asthma attack, do not use anyone else's inhaler. Right? What they tell you to do is get a brown paper bag, breathe in and out of that bag until emergency services can get there, or you get up, or someone can get you to a doctor. But you do not use someone else's medication. Right? And that's my inhaler. You do not use. And so many times I've gone out without, I used to go out without my inhaler. But I always, at one stage, I used to carry a paper brown, a little paper bag. It doesn't have to be brown, I wouldn't say. Paper bag. And have it folded up in my bag. It was always in my bag. Because my inhaler, I had three. One for upstairs, one for downstairs, and one for the kitchen and the garden. So I always had an inhaler when I was at home. But sometimes I forget to pick one of those inhalers up. So if I ever did have an asthma attack, I knew I had the paper bag. Exactly. Why is it they've told out information, which is now publicly put out on a Facebook page post, but they won't come out and say so to the press? Why? Do they find it easy just to let the family tell us? It's not making sense. None of this case is making. Right. So I'm just catching up on some of the messages. None of it is making any sense. It's just so crazy. It's unbelievable. Why won't they come out and say, yes, they took the polygraph. Yes, they passed. Why won't they? They've told Robin Rogers they passed, but they won't tell anyone else. They won't come out publicly and say that Katie Prideful and Chris Prideful both took polygraphs and they both passed. Why? Yeah, it makes you wonder that second post, doesn't it? Especially when you read that, right? Just go, not to keep spreading rumours, it's hurting the family. But not long before she did that one, she put this out. Right? She put this out. Shame on Chris Prideful and shame on Clumangat, who reportedly speaks with him daily. How dare you make a mockery of my... Now, this sounds like Robin. When she's in public, like when she was at that vigil, she did say she's totally different. She was going, stop all this hatred, stop all the rumours, stop all this. We're here for one thing and one thing only, Sebastian. I thought, yes, we are. Just stop it all. But then she comes. And then, not too long later, she comes out with this. That does not make sense. To see this. To see this one. So I'm watching it on the phone as well because I watch the chat on my phone. See this one, right? And then all of a sudden, it doesn't make sense. It does not make sense. Please. Why has that been? I'd be very surprised if that was her. I'm trying to look at this and see if there's any words in there that makes me think of someone else in my everyday. Could it have been Seth? Could it have been the PR? Yeah, she used Katie in the first one, and then in this one, she used Kate. Seth wouldn't use Katie, he'd use Katie as well. A note only missing an I, K-A-T-I-E. Well, and this one is K-R-A-T-E. But as I just said, my sister's Kathleen, and she will not go by Kate or Kath. I think she, like, family, if she was in the house at my mum's, we could go Kath, call her like that. We won't go Kathleen. You know what I mean? We call her Kath. So I think if we call Katie or Kate, I don't think she will give answers to us. Because I remember calling her Kathy or Kath, you know what I mean? Well, very rarely did I use her full name, Kathleen. Right, and she's the eldest one out of seven of us. So if I'm 58, she's a good 10 years older than me. So, 2, 4. Yeah, she's a good 10 years older than me, so she's 68, 69. Yeah, Kate, Robin uses the name Katie. I've got other messages of hers somewhere. Hold on. I'm going to pull them up. I've got them here. Oh, guys, it's just finding the right one there. That's just. To see. Hold on. I'm gonna get somewhere. Okay, let's have a look. The one post you feel is true, she calls her Katie. Yes, that Seth says Katie. Who calls her Kate? Has anyone heard anyone, like, would CP call her Kate? But to get that, to get into Robin's Facebook page, you'd have to log in. It could be just a mistake on the grandmother's behalf by not putting I in it. You know what I mean? But it just doesn't sound right. That first one, she's having a go at them, and all of a sudden it's like, don't have a go at CP and KP. They have done a polygraph. They have passed. Do we care about the polygraphs? No. Because they know how to beat it. You can beat a polygraph. It makes no sense. I think that everyone, someone else has writ. Right? Because it doesn't make sense. We'll decide one thing and then all of a sudden go back on it. That does not make sense. But anyway, while I'm in my emails, we will discuss CP. Right. This is, I'll go bit by bit because that's how it's screenshot. Bye. And I will zoom in. Right, as far as I can go. Seth and Associates. I have had time to consider this dog handler matter. And the other request that you have mentioned, my answers are as follows. One, hang on. Oh, yeah. So, right, the second part is on the next piece. One, dog handler. If you wish to use a dog handler to search, that is fine. However, after talking with law enforcement agencies and the dog handler and anyone else is being denied access to our house and property. Any form of permission to set foot on our property, as well as any family member's property, is being denied as well. What have you got to hide? This is our official statement. And we ask that our wishes and privacy be respected at this time. Thank you for understanding. Privacy. Your son, stepson, is missing. And you want to get out of here. Right? Second part. Number two. I'm just waiting for it to come up on your screen. I posted a comment on one of your videos about turning you wanting Seth. Yeah. Yeah, CP calls us. I'm sure it does, yeah. Even in this, it goes Chris and Katie, you know what I mean? So who would call her Kate? Whoever calls her Kate is the one who wrote that same message. Put it that way. Anyway, number two of that email, Tony Mathis. I'm still looking into this and have no answer for you at this time. We have spoken to Mr. Mathis and are considering it with each other as well as going for. Please, please, someone tell me why you keep bringing law enforcement. Can you not go and do a poop without asking law enforcement? For feck's sake, you've got to brain. You're okay to discuss it. You don't have to say, well, we've got this guy called Tony Mathis. Seth Rogers wants him as a PR. Should we actually agree to this? Should we join up with Tony Mathis and Seth? What are they going to say? Well, no, because Tony Mathis is this guy. They don't know. It's up to you and Katie, not you, Katie, and the fucking law enforcement. Every question, even in that other one, it was about law enforcement. You know what I mean? That is right about the dog handler to serve. That is fine. However, after talking with Ali agencies and Katie, why to continue calling? Yeah, I think someone's stolen the pot with that message. Not this one. That one with someone with Robin Rogers. Someone may have hacked your account. Because there are people out there who can hack. I can't. I have trouble getting into my own fucking account, never alone anyone else's. I had to log into my own personal Facebook page to get on my phone. I'm thinking, oh my God. What email is it? And what password do I use? You know what I mean? So I'd be no good as hacking, as a hacker. I really wouldn't. I have trouble hacking into getting into my own. But yeah. Someone is stirring the pot on that one. We'll go back to that. All right. We can get back to that. See, notice in my emails, I've got it as CP, liar, liar, pants on fire. Yeah. Now, young, I'm going to make a conversation. I just want to highlight it again. CP, liar, liar, pants on fire. I have to put it with something quirky like that, otherwise I forget. Oh, God's sake, I want to go down, not up. Yeah, these are, that's Robin Rogers. That is Robin Rogers. That is Robin Rogers. So, oh, come on. So that's Robin Rogers. If I wrote something like that, and then someone said, my son come to me and said, Mom, I put things up on my Facebook page, my own personal Facebook page. And I've had my kids come to me, Mom, pardon me? What? It's my Facebook page. If they don't like it, scroll on by. Scroll on by, I don't care. I am not taking down my thoughts or my opinions. You know what I mean? Not in my life. So, if my... be me, and my son said, Mom, you can't put that up there. I've gone, why? Why? It's my page. I can say what I want. Right? And then she puts up this one. Right? The two are totally different. See, by putting this one up, this is the one that's causing the more drama, believe it or not, this second one. Because it's in real contrast to the first one. It's like, oh, okay, I shouldn't have said that. I'll post something else. I'll put this up about TBI and about the polygraphs and about this and about... No. No. That, this one does not make sense. And I would be, if I was in Tennessee, right, and I saw that, I'd be going, so you can talk to the grandmother, but you can't tell press, even though she's put it all over Facebook, and now it'll be all over YouTube and Instagram and wherever you want to be, right? It's there. Yeah. It's something not right about it. It's just, that doesn't sound right. It doesn't sound like, if she could put that out in the first place, I'd have believed it. Right? If that was the only comment she put out was that one, then I'd have believed it. And I could put the name thing, Kate down as a mistyping error. Because it's just the eye that's missing. But the fact that she put that first one out, that other one out first, and then put this one out, doesn't make sense. And I would be furious as well. Why won't the police come out and say something? Why? Could it be someone's hacked her account? I must put this out because it's making CP and KP look really good. They've been interviewed, both CP and KP, extensively. They've been colleague and past. Yes, Kate. See, I'm going to say Katie, but you've got Kate. Took more than one poly and passed. It's just more harm than good to be defiling into everyone's background. Talking about her, Katie's background. Right? They're wrong about Katie's background there, because we haven't been looking into Seth's. We all know about CP's background, right? But now I'm about Katie's background then. Because it mentioned the fact that Sebastian might be with his other maternal grandmother. Is all this? Yes. If there's a possibility Sebastian could be with his other maternal grandmother, then yes. Robbing your grandmother, you know better. So I don't believe that is robbing. I really don't. You know what I mean? But then again, it doesn't take much to take a photo. Right? Open up a new Facebook page on your own name. Right? Put a post out like on another Facebook page or wherever she put it. You wouldn't get much to open up a Facebook. So, but that is all making KP and CP look so good and so innocent. And no, that is not robbing. If she comes back on TV and says, that was me, that statement up, I'd be going, what the hell are you thinking, woman? What the hell are you thinking, putting that statement up like that? I think... it's not me. It's not me, honest. I haven't done it. Right? Princess Kate, yeah, I am joking. Oh, dear. But it's easily done. You hear people saying how their pages have been, what do they call it? When people take a photo and put it on another Facebook page and your name. What do they call that on Facebook? Because I see people coming up daily. Well, not daily, but weekly at least. Coming up and saying, if you get any of a friend request off me, it's not my account. You know what I mean? So you have other people opening up accounts in your name and taking your pictures and everything. And opening up a new Facebook account. And believe it or not then, those people are the ones who can get into your bank accounts, because once you accept them as a friend, right, they can get into your bank account. If you've got a bank account attached to your Facebook account, don't be so silly. If I've had to email, I've had to message people and say, look, I've had to open a new Facebook page. This is me. This is the real me. Please accept my invite. Right? And I've gone around and I've had, because someone's hacked my other account, you know what I mean? And I've not been able to get into it. So I've had to open up another Facebook page. So now, I've got something like, I don't know how many people I've got on my other Facebook page, something like 80-something people. And once I go through that list again, it'll probably get chopped down to about 60. Because every so often I'll go through and I think, well, I haven't heard of that person. I haven't heard of that person. I haven't heard of that person. They've never commented or liked any of my posts. So I'll delete them. And eventually I'll get down to just having my son, my daughter, my daughter-in-law, my grandson, my son-in-law, my daughter-in-law's mother, my son's mother-in-law, two friends, possibly three, my sister, my nephew, and my niece. There's 11. It'll get down to about 11 people eventually in my personal account. Because after I got hacked that time, I don't trust no one. Someone got into my ever Facebook group page that I do for children, for birthdays and Christmases. And they kicked me off, they took me off as admin and kicked me out the group. And luckily my other admin was able to find out who it was, block them, get them out, so then she could send me the invite. Because every time it sent me the invite, it wouldn't let me on. Because she blocked me as well. So she got rid of this person on the page, dummy, and unblocked me, sent me the invite again, then had to add me as admin. I thought, I wouldn't mind, but this is my flipping group. I started this group, and I'm getting kicked off it. Oh no, it wasn't my kids' page. It was another page I did for my 5D diamond art. That is it. I've got several pages, one for children and one for my diamond art. And they kicked me off my own diamond art page. I'm going, no way. Now, this woman, my admin, she's brilliant on that page. Absolutely brilliant. In this case, have you noticed, SG? Right? That phone call got released on Thursday, yes? All over YouTube Thursday. I mentioned it on Friday, but I was not going to play it Friday. If you remember, you and my blogger quickly, I'll let you be my friend. Oh. Honestly, it's getting down to the point where I've just have blood, well, apart from the odd couple of friends that I know in Dundee, where I live. Apart from that, I know about one, two. I've got actual friends where I've got one, two, three. No, one, two. Yeah, three, four. Any more? No. We was having this discussion the other week because I was on about my funeral plan. Because I'm paying for my funeral, right? For when that big day comes and I go to meet my maker, right? And I was saying how, when I was talking to the guy on the phone, the man on the phone, about setting it up, he's saying, well, this one you can have 50 people go. I went, 50? He went, yeah. He said, it's not a lot, is it? I went, that's too many. And he laughed. I went, I'm not laughing. I'm serious. 50 people at my funeral? No. Right? And he said, well, we've got this plan where you can have 20. 20 was the minimum it would go down to. I went, 20. He went, yeah. I went, I said, okay, I'll have that one. I said, but there won't be 20 people at my funeral. He said, don't be silly. I said, I'm being deadly serious. I said, because I've just mentioned everyone who I know. And if there's more than less than 11 people, right? Say 10. I said, if there's more than 10 at my funeral, then all those who are family, and even family members, if some of my family, I've told my son and my daughter, if certain family members turn up at my funeral, kick them out. Because I've not heard of them since I was last down in Birmingham in 2019. Not heard of them. Even when I was took ill in 2022. Yeah, 2022, when I was took ill. Not, apart from my sister who I told, not, and she told the rest of my family. She told the rest of my family, even though I wasn't going to tell them. She told them, and not one of them come through to me to ask me how I was doing, nothing. So I said, so I don't want them at my funeral. It's fake. I don't want fake people at my funeral. I want people there who knew me, who spent time with me. You know what I mean? Do you, not just because, oh, she's my sister. No, I don't care. I don't care. I don't want you at my funeral. You may think I'm being harsh, but that's my reality. That's how I look at life. If you can't acknowledge me in life, then don't acknowledge me in death. So on my page, I'll literally be dwindling it down to about 11, 12 people. And I don't care about that because I don't know, there are some I do acknowledge. They do come through. You know what I mean? Got people on there from my other group. So, yeah, probably have about 30. You know, I've got a small little group of people who I keep myself to, and that is it. When I lived in Birmingham, there's way too many people who knew my business. Way too many people. Some people don't hear my name, my maiden name. Not my marriage name, my maiden name. And I go, oh, you've got a brother called Malcolm, or you've got a brother called Mark. And I'd look at them and go, how do you know that? Oh, we know your family. And I go, what do you mean you know my family? They make us out to sound like we're some spooks. You know what I mean? And we wasn't. We wasn't. But because they knew my maiden name, right? They backed off. They were back away from me. So, fine. Oh my gosh, too funny. Exactly. See me while I'm alive. I was adopted. Just met my blood relatives. And so I have a Facebook page for blood relatives with an only child. Was an only child. That's fair enough, you know what I mean? You got, what, 10 siblings? Wow. Wow. There's 7 in my family, 7 children altogether in my mum and dad's family, right? I'm the 2nd youngest. But I only keep in contact with one. As I said, the others haven't been in contact, not even when they found out I was ill. And my sister told my one brother that. And we were talking about it the other week, they said, well, how do you know? He probably hasn't said anything to the family. I said, what? You don't know my family then? Because if someone is told something, that is like Chinese whispers in my family. Did you hear about this? And that member will go to the next member. Did you hear about Angela? Did you hear? Do you know what I mean? It's Chinese whispers in my family. So you don't have to tell everyone. You just have to tell one person in my family something. And I can guarantee you the rest of the family are going to find out. My brother said to me at my mum's funeral, as I was leaving, he said, I suppose I'll see you in 10 years' time. Because that's how long it's been since I've been back down to Birmingham. I went, well, you know where I live. Nothing's stopping you from coming up to Scotland to me. Why should I keep going down to Birmingham, where I hate Birmingham. I really do. I don't feel comfortable there no more. I really don't. I get there and I think 3-4 days is my limit, and then I need to get back home to Scotland. I can't cope. Can't deal with it. Last time we went down for my mum's funeral, I can't remember what day it was on. I can't remember if it was a Friday or whatever. But we went down the day before the funeral. We drove down, me and my daughter and her partner, drove down to Birmingham. We stopped one night, went to the funeral the next day. Then when we left the funeral, my daughter wanted to pop into the city centre, to the shops. Not my thing. But we went into the city centre, spent a couple of hours walking around there, and got in the car and drove all the way back to Scotland. I couldn't get back here quick enough. I miss my sister, and I miss my nephew and my niece. You know what I mean? I do miss them. But Scotland's my home. Like, you know, people say, I can't wait to get back home. That's me. If I leave Scotland, it's like, do I really have to go? Do I really have to go to England? Do I? I remember once I went down by a coach and I traveled down during the night. Because it's like an eight hour trip by coach. I thought I could sleep most of the way, you know what I mean? Which I did. Anyway, I got off the coach and I got my bags off the coach. And there's like a queue of taxis behind this coach. And I'm holding my bags. I looked at these taxis and I just dropped my bags, just literally dropped my bags on the floor. And thought, what the hell are you doing here? Honest to God. Staying in Scotland for one day. Oh, you need a good. I've been up here since 2008. And there's places I'd love to go and see. Places. Right. And I'm seriously thinking of booking it, like, because I don't drive. I'm seriously thinking of booking a coach tour thing, which takes a couple of weeks, can take about a week or so. And it takes you from one place to another. You probably spend one day at this one place or night, overnight. You know what I mean? And travel around Scotland like that on my own. I'd love it on my own. But I'd miss my family. I'd miss my kids. You went to Europe twice. I've been to Europe. And we're not Europe now. We're not EU. UK is not EU. We're not under the EU no more. So CP, you said in a comment once when you was on a YouTube channel. I think it was to the English, this other English YouTuber. You said, well, I don't understand the EU rules and all this law. We're not EU. We're UK. We don't come under the EU no more. 50 years ago. Right. And I've been to Europe. I've been to Amsterdam. I've been to Germany. Germany is beautiful. Honest to God, it's beautiful, Germany is. But I went to visit my brother at the time, who's in the armed forces. And we went there. Where else have I been? I've been to South of France. That is beautiful as well. South of France is beautiful. I've been through France. I've been through Belgium. I spent a day in Belgium. Right. Well, 2 days actually. I've been to Belgium twice. I've been to Spain. So I've been a few times abroad, but that's in like 58 years. I've been that many times. I wouldn't go again. You know what I mean? Scotland, I want to see more of Scotland. So I'm seriously going to look into booking a week's tour around certain places of Scotland. Just going away for a week on a tour bus sort of thing from one place to another. Take my phone, my laptop. Take plenty of videos and pictures. But anyway, we're getting off subject. And I've got a lot to talk about. Right. Did anyone see that Nancy Grace interview? We know we heard the audio, but the interview is out now.
Why?
Now, I didn't click onto this, but in the interview, apparently, she asked Steph a question about what he thought. It's kind of like going to another state in the US, but another country. Right. Well, I'm glad you got back together with your family. I'm glad you're doing that. But, right, now in that interview, I haven't watched it yet. I've heard the audio, but I must have missed it on the audio because apparently they asked Seth, she asked Seth, what his thoughts were or something like that of what could have happened, yeah? And Seth stated, in his opinion, he thinks that Katie might have overdosed Sebastian. Well, apparently, his PR, Seth left the panel, come off the panel, and the interview was supposed to stop or carry on without Seth, but she didn't. Well, they carried the interview on, but when they edited it, they cut it out. So when Seth left the panel, come off the panel, that's when it finished. And apparently his PR was not happy that they brought CP and KP into it, and they said they would edit that bit out. And they didn't. So apparently he wasn't happy about that. But now he's had a change of mind and say we can say whatever we like about them. Well, Tony, had to just destroy your dog there. We were anyway. We wasn't bothered whether you saying we couldn't talk about them. You're the one who wouldn't talk about them, not us. And to be honest with you, for nearly 2 weeks, we didn't, because we was all focused on that one picture until it came out that it wasn't him. And now people there's still people going around saying it was AI generated. It wasn't. That picture is real. They had it confirmed by the woman who posted it, the woman whose husband took it. TBI confirmed it was not AI generated. So, but there's still people on interviews saying it was AI generated. So, I've got Ziggy Hill on my TV at the moment. Goes under a married name now, not just Ziggy, it's Ziggy Hill. Because if you hadn't really heard, Ziggy and Fred Hill from Ben Hill Road got married. So congratulations to them both. But they got married a few weeks ago now. What's this one next year? I don't trust the alleged text messages because last time something allegedly leaked from Nancy Grace, it wasn't true. Yeah, Nancy Grace spoke about that, yeah. Yeah, Yeah, she said, I've got sheets of paper here from emails. From I even sent her an email. And I didn't say, all I said is, I think you need this needs to be brought to your attention because this is making you, bringing your name into this. Hold on, I'm just about to go and kill a cat. Pack it in. Right? I just put on the email, I believe you, this, you need to see this because this is bringing your name into it, which is bad. You know what I mean? So that's all I put on the email and I sent in the messages or whatever that was being said. So yeah, she spoke about that. Didn't she speak about it? Oh God. Oh, she spoke about it and they only showed you a short clip of that one, didn't they? It was just a short clip thing between her and someone else. But she did mention it. But I'm not going to play the video on here because we've listened to the audio. But apparently on there, there's supposed to be some edited out and it wasn't. Well, I don't suppose PR Tony Mathis cares no more. You know what I mean? Because Tony Mathis has thrown the gloves in. He is not caring. Right? So I don't trust this message here. This one here. It just doesn't fit right. Oh, some, I have someone to mention. I'm going to share it. It's on my YouTube, so I'm going to just take this off. Close it down. Right. Now, remember the last interview, the police enforcement and TBI's done? And I mentioned about United Cajun Navy not receiving any complaints from them. Right? Now we know We know Chris had complaints in because he himself and his searches were being followed and intimidated. When you follow people in a car or whatever, it's like intimidation, you know what I mean? So it's a form of intimidation. So they... And yet law enforcement said that they'd received no complaints. They'd received none from anyone, not United Cajun Navy, no one. And... apparently, that's Steph, the other woman with the dogs. She said she put complaints in, but I'm not sure now. I really don't know what to believe no more with that. Right? But this, I just want to remind Sumner County, we know right? We know complaints have gone in. We know that. They're not going to say, oh, we put a complaint, especially Seth. Right? Now, Chris has put complaints in. Right? They said they were getting harassed and whatever at the beginning, remember? And they told police about all that. Listen to this. All right, I'm just going to present it up.
Are we able to learn anything about what those threats are?
They would have to call the police and report them.
They've claimed they've received threats. To your knowledge, have they filed any police reports or?
Right. Now, last I knew, and we called them right because we know people are putting complaints. He shouldn't have said it if he didn't want to. Who shouldn't have said what? Are we talking about Chris or Mike? Right. But he would have known, the PI would have told him as well that that phone call was being recorded. Right. Because I don't know what, like, it's a bit weird. Like, in some states over there, you've got a one person rule. And in another state, you could get a two person rule. Right. Something like that. I don't understand. I don't know what the rules are over here for recording people. I'd have to check that out myself. Oh. No, he shouldn't have said it. He shouldn't have said that if he didn't want it out. He should have said, but you know, Seth isn't one for being diplomatic. He isn't. He says it from what he believes, right? Now, he could have said, well, I don't want to talk about that. Right? Or I can't talk about that. You know what I mean? Anything he could have said that. But he didn't. He said it from his opinion. And his opinion is he feels she overdosed him. Right? Yeah. Seth should have been a bit more diplomatic. But he's not. He's not diplomatic. He's not going to be like that. And to be honest with you, his PR, who was on the show as well, should have stepped in and said, Nancy, we're not talking about that. Because CP and KP are not here. We're not talking about CP or KP. But he didn't. The Seth answered it to his opinion. Now, that's a possibility. I've not thought of that. I've heard people saying that. Now, that's a possibility. But could she have gave him, maybe if she's got sleeping meds, could she have used maybe one of her sleeping tablets with him? Thinking, well, like, medication isn't helping. I'll give him one of mine. And that's a no-no. You don't use other people's medication. I know I have done in the past, I've, like, for painkillers. Like, my one painkiller I can use and I know will be effective. In the UK, it's called Tramadol. Why? But if you're on it for a long time, it can be addictive. Very addictive. So, I was on it for a while with my back. When my back went on me years and years and years ago, right? And it was the only painkiller I could use. So now, if I have any back trouble, I will say to my son, have you got any Tramadol? And he'll probably say no, but I've got this. I know I'm okay with most painkillers, but I prefer my Tramadol because that just kill the pain. Now, I've been in pain all day yesterday afternoon and today, last night, today, now. Because I went out with my grandson and was up walking up steps and uphill, right? And then I'm running around this play park area with him. And then we've walked back home and my leg was killing me, but I've took no pain relief for it. Took no pain relief for it at all. So It's still there, yeah. If I move my leg, I feel that still. There's no pain. Yes, I think it's sugar scepting. Well, they did on one show, someone mentioned KP and CP on one YouTube channel. It said, we're not going to answer that because KP and CP are not here. So we're not answering any questions on KP or CP. He did then. Why didn't he do it on Nancy Grace? That's what Seth has him for, to keep him in check, sort of thing, to make sure he doesn't say anything he shouldn't say. So, anyway, it's 10:15. I'm going to stop this crazy train that we're on, putting out. Crazy train, we'll be back again tomorrow. And as promised, and I don't care what comes up tomorrow. I really don't. Unless it's about Sebastian. Unless it's about Sebastian, I don't want to hear it. I really don't. I don't want to hear about a friend who used to work with him, a neighbour, an old colleague. I don't want to hear none of that. I want to hear something about Sebastian. I want to hear Seth come on a YouTube channel and talk about Sebastian. That I would post, I would share that. You know what I mean? I don't want all this negativity. So, starting tomorrow. Thank you, SG. Right. Starting tomorrow. No more. CP. KP, nothing, right? Don't want to hear about them and what's going on with Seth. But I do want to hear about it. I just won't talk about it on my show, right? So tomorrow, I'm going to go back. I keep saying this, but something keeps coming up. And we are going to look at the four-part interview of Chris and Katie. That four-part interview. The first interview they did with, who was it with? WSMV4. We're going to look over that tomorrow. I was going to do some map time tonight. But as I said, this is all gone. It's just crazy. Just crazy on the YouTube streets. So we can even get some map time. Just look at, the reason I want to do map time is, I looked at where Calver's place is, where he goes for the ice cream. And it's a good 10-minute walk or so to get there. But I'd also like to eventually find out where be tomorrow. I doubt if I get the information by tomorrow. But I'd like to get the information as the route they will take to Clarksville. Because Sebastian knew that route. Now, okay, you might be thinking, why are you going over these routes? We know it's not going to be there. No, but it could be along there somewhere. This could be somewhere. Because you notice that one interview they did, when he mentioned about how he knows to get to his father's in Clarksville, and she elbowed him. She gave him that little bit of an elbow. As though to say, say that. Don't say that. Could they have dumped his body, put his body somewhere along that way? So I just want to look, find out the route. Right? But there's a couple of routes. So we might just, if I get to time, I might just do it anyway and have a look at the routes they could take to Clarksville. Aye. Even though I don't think, but then again, you don't know. No, I'm not going there. He did not walk out that house. He didn't. Can't be done. No scent, no trail, no sign of him He did not walk out that house. So, Katie, please. It's Mother's Day there. It's Mother's Day in the USA. Please, for the sake of your son, come forward and talk. For the sake of your child, come and talk. Apparently, she's supposed to go on a live on Crime Stories Obsessed, I think, the other night. But then this phone call came out, so it all went up in the air. You see, the thing is, would he be there while she's on the phone? Would he be holding up these little scripts for her to read? You know what I mean? Off camera. Even if she was on off camera or not, would she be reading from a script? Because he's got so much control over her. She's not stupid, but he's got a control over her. And that's scary. Especially when you think of his family. And if I find that interview, I'm sure it was on Jail for Justice. If I find it, I'll play some of it maybe tomorrow night near the end. But before I do anything tomorrow night, I want to just go back to the beginning. Just go back to the beginning. And let's get this talking again, getting his name back out there again. So remember, everyone, we're here for one person and one person only. And that is Sebastian Wayne Drake Rogers, 15-year-old autistic lad, went missing, was reported missing on the 26th of February. Not been seen, no sign of him, no trace of him, nothing. It's now 76 days, did I say? Yeah. Apparently 76 days. I'm not sure how many. I'll have to confirm that. But I think it's 76 days now. So I'm going to say thank you to everyone who's been here. It's all right, my phone's died, so I can't see. I was watching off my laptop. So thank you for everyone being here, everyone from Twitter. Thank you for being here. Please, thank you for the green hearts, SG. Thank you. Please, on Twitter, if you can, put some green hearts up for him. Please. Think of Sebastian and get them green hearts out there. Okay, then. Thank you all for being here. I really do appreciate this. And we're going to leave with this again. I always go out with the same video I come in with. And then I'll do the ending. So let's stop this. Don't want to see his ugly mush anymore. And thank you all again. Good night.